get up before the rooster. Put on my camo. Load up my bow and my rifle and stock the ammo. I'm a bullet with the bullet, but I'm lethal with the arrow. Always down for the hunt, dub turkey and big bucks. Hit the woods and get fitted up. Mossy oak all across my fit, don't be surprised. We do this too.
I'll be up before the sun with my 30 at 6. Hard body on, I ain't worried about the kick. Yeah, we do this too.
What's up, guys? Welcome to another edition of the We Do This Too Outdoors Podcast. I'm your host, Courtney Williamson, and I got a special guest here with us today, Mr. Bryant Jones. How you doing, sir?
Good, sir. How about yourself?
Thank you, brother. Yes, sir. So me and Bryant met back in the day through a mutual friend. I think it was through Mr. Ryan Patton. Shout out to Big Pat. Played a little softball back in the day, and he's an African-American hunter just like myself, man. So real blessed to have you on today, man, and talk about some hunting and everything like that, man. So introduce yourself, man. Go ahead.
Yeah, like C. Will said, my name is Bryant Jones. Avid hunter, avid baseball player. Love to get out in the woods as much as I can. Man, started this thing when I was little, so just happy to be here. Happy to talk with C. Will. Good to catch up. Hopefully get out in the woods soon and do a little hunting together ourselves.
For sure, for sure. So explain to the viewers, man, how you first fell in love with outdoors and hunting.
Man, I think it just like, most little boys my age look like me. My dad took me out in the woods and kind of showed me the roundabouts to the game. And, started out doing a little squirrel hunting, and he had a bunch of beagles and some rabbits, and got into deer hunting when I was old enough to hold the rifle. And from there on, I was hooked.
Heck yeah, man. So where'd you grow up hunting at?
Wadi, Kentucky. I don't know.
Wadi, Kentucky.
Yeah, small town. Wasn't much to do out there. So yeah.
Is that the western part of the state?
That's Shelby County. It's Central Kentucky.
Central Kentucky, gotcha. Yeah. Wadi, Kentucky, man. Heck yeah. So as you grew up and started, hunting yourself by yourself, so what gave you the drive to be outdoors? Is it your father instill that in you, or is it just something that you just had to be out there? You know what I'm saying?
Man, I think the old saying is, it runs deep in your blood. I grew up hunting. I kind of got away from it a little bit, went to college, played baseball, and then kind of got back. And I don't know, I wouldn't call it bored life, but I kind of had that void in me, and I got back into hunting. And, come to find out, my grandfather, he had bird dogs. My other grandfather had bird dogs. My uncle's bird hunted. Of course, my dad introduced me to it. And ever since I got back into it, it just feels like, it's been therapy to me. So it feels like I'm full again.
I heard that. Yeah, that's how it is for me, man. Like, I started when I was a kid. My dad took me. My dad, the only thing he hunted was rabbits and quail. Like, didn't hunt deer, nothing like that. So I kind of had to teach myself how to do everything. Deer hunt wise, turkey wise, dove wise, duck wise, rabbits, he could teach me everything, quail, he could teach me everything, but everything else I had to learn by myself, man. And I fell in love with it. So, what's your favorite thing to hunt now?
Man, I'm hooked on these ducks, man.
Yeah, I hear you, dog.
Ducks, they do it for me.
Man, my buddy took me last year with two of my buddies. Shout out to Lance and McKenzie, man. They took me out to Ballard County, and, dude, from the first time them ducks started coming in, like, there's no feeling. Like, I get buck fever real bad. Like, but that, dude, like, it was insane. I was scared to death at first because, I got two of my boys out there. We're hunting flooded timber. I'm scared of water. I can't swim. We're on this boat. It's freezing. And they're like, man, we're probably going to hit some stumps going back through here. And I'm like, what you mean we're about to hit some stumps?
Yeah.
He's like, just hold on. So I sat down in the middle of the boat because I'm scared to death.
Mm-hmm.
So my buddy Lance is like, dude, once we get back here and get set up, like, it'll be fine. So we got back here and I got the water. I'm like, so we're standing here. He's like, yeah, we're going to stand here until daylight and start calling. So I'm like, I don't know about this, but. From the first time them ducks started coming in, like, that adrenaline rush, they ain't nothing like it, man. So I've been bit by the bug, something awful, man. I can't wait.
Ain't nothing like it.
So yeah, I cannot wait, man.
Yeah, I started hunting about, I guess, ducks about 5 years ago. I was out there. I took my buddy out to a farm pond I'd access to fish on. He asked me, man, you duck hunt? I was like, no. He said, man, you're sitting on a gold mine here. So we got out there about the next couple weeks, and they came pouring in. I was like, yeah, that's what I want to do. And ever since then, I've spent, you know, ain't no telling how much money. Got a new dog, got all kinds of accessories. So, like you said, I'm ate up with it.
I hear you, man. Yeah. So what kind of gear are you running in the duck woods, man? What kind of shotgun you got, decoys, wakers? Run it down for me.
Man, you know, I got the Beretta shotgun, A4.
Gotcha.
Using that. As far as decoys, I got the Avions, you know, the Avions out there. Got some hand-me-down goose decoys, so I'm still running with those, still doing the job. We made our own blind, actually from scratch, you know, from treated lumber and all that. Got out there, and that was a good day for that. But yeah, just whatever. Well, man, I'm not a big, you know, brand guy, anything like that. Just whatever gets the job done. You know, I got a bunch of mismatched stuff. Got, like I said, now it's all about my dog. I got a new blind for her and a bunch of vests and, you know, doing all the training with her. So it's all about her.
Gotcha. What kind of dog you got? You got a lab or?
No, I actually got it. It's called a poodle pointer. Not sure if you heard of that. It's a dog back in the 1800s. One of the first versatile dogs that they made to, you know, when they want to go rabbit hunting or bird hunting or track a deer. This dog would do it all. So they mix the poodle with an English pointer.
Yeah,
they're pretty rare dogs here in the United States, but got my hands on one, and you know, she's been awesome so far.
That's good, man. Yeah, me and my uncle, we run about 6 rabbit dogs. They're blue chicks. Mm-hmm. And I've got a chocolate lab, which my father-in-law currently has it. That's basically his buddy now. Okay. We first got married, the first place that we was renting until we figured out where we was gonna build or buy or whatever, you know, we couldn't have dogs, so he kind of dog sitted for us one weekend, and he was just like, hey, I'm probably going to keep him, just so y'all know. So, I mean, he's a chocolate lab. He's like 9 years old. Like, he'll go get a duck. He'll go get a dove. But right. He won't bring it back to you. He thinks it's a toy. So,
yep.
He's been house trained and everything. But, like, I want to get another dog and, you know, teach him the finer things of bird hunting. But I haven't got my wife back on that. Yeah, you know how it is.
I know exactly how it is.
Yeah, man.
The dog changed the hunting game, you know. My dad, growing up, we had anywhere from 20 to 30 beagles at a time, you know, so we'd run them all the time. And, you know, finally got my first dog here recently, and it just changed the whole game, you know. You know, they call it hunting, not killing, for a reason. And you know, the dog adds to an element of that, and it just makes it more enjoyable for me right now.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
So being out there in the woods as an African-American hunter, man, what do you see are some barriers between us getting on TV, unlike some of our Caucasian fellow mans?
Yeah. You know, I think it's, you know, it's 2023. I think we're doing better, but I think there's still some barriers out there for sure, you know. Just that, you know, I hunt with some new friends here and there. And it's always kind of a weird, you know, interaction there at first when, you know, how long you been hunting? They're real curious about how long I've been hunting, you know, and you know, most other people don't get those kind of questions. So they're real curious about my past and, you know, how I got into it. But, you know, I think it just goes back to the old, you know, stereotype, you know, that the hunt games for more Caucasians and not many African-Americans get out there and do it. And, you know, just like your title says, we do this too, you know? So
that's right.
Yeah.
When I first started this, man, like I said, like I was getting some flack kind of from both sides, mostly from my own race.
Yep.
Thinking I was a sellout, you know, trying, you know, why am I trying to get into this white boy sport? I'm like, dude, I've been doing this since I was a kid.
Mm-hmm.
I was like, I'm just telling my story and what I love to do. And I said, you know, there's a lot of us out there, but, you know, we just don't get the spotlight. Like, not on TV. We're not, you know, sponsored by a lot of big brands. So it was just like a lot of questions were raised. And I'm like you, man. When I go hunting with people or go out, you know, to some of these archery competitions, or I show up at the duck boat ramp or somewhere, you know, I'm the only one usually out there. It's like, hold on, let me go quiz this guy to see why he's out here. And, you know, it's just, it's a different interaction, man. And, which I don't, most of the time I don't mind it, but sometimes, man, it just gets annoying. But
it gets old.
It gets old. So, but I think we're breaking down some of these stereotypes and some of these barriers, man. There's a lot of us out there, you know. Shout out to, you know, 24/7 Hunt Boys and what they do. Jim Caesar down in Louisiana. I don't know if you follow him or not. Most of those guys, you know, it's just like, you know, they're kind of getting on the big stage where people can see, you know, what we do. So mm-hmm. I'm excited about where this brand goes, man, and see what we can do, man, for sure.
Absolutely. And I'm with you, you know, it's more of a, you know, you get more pushback from my own race than we do, you know, anybody else. You know, it's always like, you know, why are you out there doing that, you know? But, you know, like we say, we grew up doing it. We're staying true to ourselves. You know, we talk about keeping it real. We're just keeping it real like we grew up doing. And I know it's, like we said, it filled a big void in my life. So I'm just glad to be back doing this.
For sure, man. So I know you said you played baseball growing up, but as did I. Still doing the baseball teaching thing? Are you still doing that?
Yeah, full fledged on that. Help a guy out with this facility. I give my own company doing private lessons, coach a couple teams, help out in high school baseball as much as I can. Just that, you know, that's another piece of me that I grew up doing. So I want to keep that around so I can kind of stay grounded for myself. But yeah, still doing that full time pretty much.
Got you. Yeah. Do you, most of your clients know that you're a hunter as well? So, Do y'all have that conversation quite a bit to some of your clients and whatever?
Oh yeah. Most of them know because, about this time of the year, I kind of disappear a little bit. You know, I'm going out of town to hunt and get away in a little bit. So they're well aware that I hunt. And, you know, my teams, I kind of send a lot of training videos of my dog because I'm pretty proud of it, you know, through that little thread. And they compliment back, like, man, how'd you get to train that well? And always curious when we come back on trips how she did. So, yeah, she's became a part of the baseball family as well.
That's cool, man. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, when I was in college, man, I hung around with a bunch of guys I met. And most of them were from the city. Mm-hmm. And I knew they knew I was country just because of the way I talked. But, you know, I kind of hid the fact that I was a, you know, outdoorsman because I wanted to fit in so well because I come from a little small town, Magnolia, Kentucky, man. And, you know, when I found some people that actually looked like me, you know, had the same interest in me, man, I was just like, all right, I don't know how they're going to take this if I tell them this. But, mm-hmm. A lot of them now know that, but I think they always knew that I had, you know, what I was doing on the weekends when I said I was going home during rifle season or rabbit season like that, man. So did you get any flack from any of your friends growing up when you told them, you know, that you were an outdoorsman, a hunter and fisher? Did they kind of look at you strange and be like, man, like, what?
so not so much in Shelby County. Shelby County is kind of a rural county, you know. It's everybody kind of hunts and fishes there. But once I went to college down in Tennessee, you know, it's kind of a more diverse environment, you know. And I'm like you. I kind of hid that as well and to try to fit in because I didn't know anybody down there.
Right.
I have abandoned hunting and fishing, honestly, while I was in college. But, yeah, I was the same as you. I didn't really want to tell them because, like, how are these guys going to take that, you know, because – you know, I didn't know. Just came back, and once I was going to college, I kind of got back into it a little bit. But yeah, that's a big thing. You know, you just don't know how people are going to take it. You're trying to make new friends and try to fit in everywhere. So you just want to be part of the crowd. But you know, and that's sometimes not part of the crowd being of our color. You know,
for sure.
Yeah.
Heck yeah, man. So what are some of your upcoming goals for this season, whether in the duck woods or deer woods? What you got going, man?
Yeah, man, duck season should open up here in about, I think, Thanksgiving weekend, so definitely going to be out there doing that. But I guess first deer season opens up, I'll definitely be in the blind. I think my trophy days of deer hunting is about over, just out there trying to fill the freezer. So, you know, first thing kind of walks by, I'm probably give it a look and, you know, hopefully get some meat in the freezer. But then after that, you know, it's strictly ducks. So, goals for this year, definitely getting my dog some exposure. Like I said, it's all about her this year. So definitely get her some exposure, ducks and geese and, you know, different kind of hunting, field hunting over water, you know, different environments, get her trained really well. And just have a good time, meet some new people. You know, this hunting stuff has definitely introduced me to a lot of people in my life, expanded my, you know, my career, but my, you know, just circle of friends that I talk to every day. So, you know, I don't think without hunting, you and I wouldn't be here today. So, you know, just thankful for that, for sure.
For sure, man. Yeah. That's awesome. Getting that dog some exposure, man, for sure. But so I don't know why your trophy days are over just yet, but
man,
I'm still trying to add to the wall back here. I got, you know, there's 2, 3, 4, 5. I got 5 of them on the wall in here, man. I'm going to try to keep adding. Like, I always thought I wasn't going to be the guy that, you know, was always about the antlers, man. But it's hard sometimes, man, when you're seeing some of these pictures of these monsters these guys are killing. I'm just like, all right, I want one like that too, you know. So I get it. You can't eat the horn, so.
You're right. But, hey, the first time I went out, I think I was like 10 years old. And I got the mount in my living room in there. 10 years old, first time I was in the woods, wasn't in there no more than 6 minutes. Killed the biggest buck of my life. Next year, came out about 10 minutes, killed another big buck. So just growing up around that, I'm not saying the thrill's over, but I've been right there.
So I get it. Yeah, my major goals this year, man, like I said, I want to kill some ducks. Like, I'm doing the deer thing. You know, I've been in it for a while. The turkeys tagged out, you know, opening weekend, turkey season, you know, doves. But, dude, I'm telling you, I'm ready to kill as many greenheads, geese, wood ducks, whatever. Like, if it's flying, it's dying.
Yeah.
Like, I'm ready, man. Like, as soon as you give me that call, I'm gone. I done told my wife, I'm putting new tires on my truck tomorrow. I'm ready to roll whenever you give me that call, dog. So,
ain't nothing like hunting those waterfowl. I don't know what it is, but it's got me hooked. And, you know, just getting out there in the morning, pitch black, setting up, watching the world wake up, having some coffee, shooting some jokes, killing some birds. Man, it's something else. Can't explain.
Sure. Yeah, man, I was talking to a guy at work today, man. He's a big duck hunter too. And he said Arkansas is no longer the capital for ducks. He said they're mostly going towards Oklahoma and stuff now. So what do you feel about that?
Never been to Oklahoma. Never been to Arkansas either. I know I've been to Missouri. Missouri's starting to get hot on the map a little bit. Took a random trip to Minnesota this year too. They hold some ducks up there as well, just right across the border from Canada. So they get those migrators coming down. But probably Arkansas is on my map. Want to hunt there for sure soon. And Texas is a big one. I heard Texas got a lot of ducks down there. So
Texas, huh?
Texas. That's where they end up at. So yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. I haven't heard that yet. But yeah, I've heard Arkansas is a place, a good place. Oklahoma.
Kansas.
I've been watching a lot of like these snow geese videos lately on YouTube, and I'm like, I'm pretty interested because you can kill as many as you want. You ain't gotta have a plug in your gun. I'm like, man, that's right up my alley right there, man.
A lot of birds.
Video you sent me earlier, I was like, wow, I gotta get on these, man. They roll deep.
A lot of birds, yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. So yeah, we were out in Missouri in that video I sent you. We were done hunting and we pulled over on the side of the road and it was this big field of just, I don't know, I couldn't even tell you the number, 10,000 snow geese. This bald eagle came down and kind of got them crazy, kind of got them to swirl a little bit, and those birds started flying and going crazy, and a couple of them fell down. That bald eagle came in and swooped a couple of them up. So yeah, just seeing stuff like that too, you know, just while you're out duck hunting is a big thing to me, you know, just understand how nature works.
Yeah, for sure, man. It's a lot of world out there, man. And I want to go explore it all, man, for sure. But
absolutely.
Yeah, man, I know it's getting late, man. So I'm going to ask you one question I ask all my guests, man. Okay. Money is no object. You can go anywhere and hunt anything, either in the United States, in the world, wherever. What you hunting and where you hunt?
That's a tough one. I love my ducks, but I probably have to go to Utah to hunt some elk.
That's on my bucket list, man.
Yeah, for sure. I've been out to Colorado once hunting elk, but Utah, I heard, is another level. So, yeah.
Yeah, I've heard that too, man. Yeah, I'd like to go out to Colorado or Montana somewhere and elk hunt, man. I've been putting in for the drawing here in Kentucky for I don't know how long. It ain't never happened, man. So
no, I know a lot of people like that. You know, I don't know what's going on up there, but yeah, it's hard to come by here.
Heck yeah, man. But yeah, man, tell everybody how they can get in touch with you, man, if they want to reach out about duck hunting or have any questions, man.
Yeah, just follow me on Instagram, Wadi Ferryon, W-A-D-Y-S,
Ferryon. Good, man. So, well, guys, it's kind of been a short one, but it's kind of late, man. I got to get the youngin' to bed and everything. But I appreciate Mr. Brian Jones coming on to holler at me, man. And hey, I'll be waiting on that phone call, bro.
Yes, sir. Coming soon.
Yes, sir. We do this too.
Yes, sir.